What's good? What's good, everybody? How's LA doing out there, y'all? What's good, man?
Hey,
we got a full house for you today. Yes, we do, baby. We got a full house, and it's gonna be a good show. I already feel it. Since the moment they walked in, their energy has been on and feeding my soul, because I was low chill, and then they're just giving me life. I want to go ahead, before I introduce them, you know who I am. It's your girl, Mysterious Jax. Welcome to another episode of Ladies Night Radio Show, y'all. You know what it is. We're coming to you live from the TGN Latinx studio, and I have a special guest co-host in the house. We got Joanna.
Hey, put my walk-up song.
Where's your walk-up?
Where's my walk-up song?
I have spoiled you, but I got you.
Joanna.
Happy Friday.
Happy Friday, baby. How are you?
I'm good. I'm, you know, tipsy right now. Came from happy hour. That's why I'm late. I'm late because
I'm not mad at that.
I was at the bar. My apologies. We went a little, you know.
Hard?
A little bit. You know how teachers do.
Yes. We just won't tell you what school you're at.
You're right.
But we got some guests in the house, Joanna.
I'm so excited. Thank you for sending me that link. It was awesome.
Yes.
I cannot wait to speak to these amazing people.
I know. So we got to watch the film before having you guys here. So we got to see it.
Beautiful.
We're not going to do no spoilers, though.
No. Spoilers.
No spoilers.
Manos arriba!
So I thought it was just gonna be the director, and he surprised me with some of the actors.
People.
Yes. So I'm gonna introduce you, and you're gonna introduce the rest of the squad here. But first, I'm gonna go ahead and introduce all the way from Texas, you guys, director. Of many films that I'm seeing, but the most recent one is The Devil's Ring. You guys, give him a round of applause for Juan Salas.
Hey, how's it going? Yo.
What's up, Juan? How are you?
I'm feeling great. We're out here in L.A. We're having a great time. I had to bring the party with me. We got Alexander Luna, the star of the movie.
Hey!
Linda Heidi in the building. I had to bring him with me. And also Jack Rain is in the building.
Hey, we got some audience members.
Hey, Jack Rain.
Yeah, we're here.
We got some audience members. Alexander, Linda, thank you so much for joining the ladies' night here.
Thank you for having us.
Of course. Is this your first time in L.A.?
No, it's not my first time.
Okay. None of you guys, right? And you're from here, Alex, right? Can I call you Alex?
Yeah.
Yes.
Are we there already?
Yeah, we're good. I think we're there already.
All right, just making sure.
If not, we got to be there.
Oh, yeah.
Keep drinking. We'll be
right,
there.
Yeah, yeah. Call me Al.
I know. It might go short enough to Al. Yeah,
what up, A? Yes, oh, my God. And you're from L.A., you said, but you moved out here when you moved out of L.A. when you were six, you said?
Yeah, when I was 6 years old, yes, ma'am.
And then they took you all the way to Texas.
Yeah, I went over there to Dallas.
And you haven't come back. What's going on? We miss you over here.
Oh, man. Hey, shout out to the family out here in South Central, man.
That's right. Give them some love. Give them some love.
My tia, my grandma, you know.
All the tias. All us. Because, you know, they're going to get mad if you forget one of them.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. You can't forget the tias.
Y,
no.
Y mi tío también, el que se duerme en el sofá.
Para que me invitan si saben cómo me pongo.
That's so dope. So how has LA been treating you guys?
Man, amazing. We've been having a great time since we got here. We got here, went straight to Malibu, then we're just driving around the beaches.
Oh, sure,
I've been having a great time. Dispensaries, we love them.
Oh, I bet you do.
We love it here.
I bet you
do. We don't want to leave.
You know, it's funny. Every time I have a friend from Texas visit LA, they're like, this is dope.
This is it.
And then you guys got to go back to Texas.
You know you can get it delivered to your hotel.
I know, I have that.
I'm aware.
Okay. I just wasn't sure. I just want to make sure. I got to take care of my people, you know. You don't let a drink and drive or smoke and drive. No, it comes to you now at your doorstep. They'll be like, your weed is here, you know.
No cops.
No cops.
Not worried about the coppers.
No. It's legal.
Awesome.
But yeah.
We had to like sneak around and we're like, hey, bro.
You know, that's insane to me how that's still something that, like, is not everyday life.
I know.
Like, it is for us now. You know,
I know.
What
y'all
mean?
Walk around Venice and smoke. I was what? I was, like, looking over my shoulder the whole time, like, the first day.
You want some? You want some?
No, the other day, like, not the other day, but, like, in the summer, we went to this festival party on the beach at Dockweiler. Why am I calling Rockweiler? Dockweiler. And we were walking, and as we're walking to the beach, we all going to the same festival, we could tell. And my friend was like, look, they're like, those girls are about to roll up. I'm going to ask them. And sure enough, they asked, you know, can we smoke with you guys? We got some too. We just needed papers. And we're like, fuck it, let's go. And that's how you make friends too. Everybody just out here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Hey, you make some really good connections.
You get a blunt,
sometimes.
Bro. You got me with a blunt. Yeah, I got you,
friend. We just needed some papers. We just needed some papers.
Hey, did we just become best friends? Did we just, become best friends?
We really did. We're like all friends on Instagram.
What's your IG, bro?
No, but yeah, so I'm excited to have you guys here. We're definitely going to jump into the film, The Devil's Ring. But you know, here on Ladies Night, we like to start the show with some chisme. Right,
Chase, man. I'm all about it.
You all about it, baby. We definitely love some chisme here. But okay, so we're gonna go ahead and jump into it. Well, hold on, let me give a round of applause to my guest for being here.
Yeah, applause.
But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and jump into it. So the first chisme, you guys, that we have for you is from Pope Francis. So he surprised everyone by declaring that having sex outside of marriage is, quote, not the most serious sin. So, which we all know you heathens be doing. So as a spiritual leader of the church, this really shocked everyone and had most religious people questioning everything. But now some of us don't, you know, have to worry about burning in hell, at least not for premarital sex.
How bitch. Do you bitch. I felt like I was going to go to hell in a handbasket, like, up until I got married.
Hey, but we got the Pope's blessing. Well, how you feel about that, Linda?
Go on ahead and fuck. Go on ahead and fuck.
Oh, shit.
You're blessed.
I agree. Blessed. I don't think it's the worst sin. I mean, I think killing somebody would be, I mean, definitely worse than having sex.
Yeah, right, so, right.
I mean, I agree with it.
Hey, what about you, Ellen?
I fuck with it. Hey! Sexually.
I didn't know where you were going.
I fucks with it.
I didn't know where you were going with that question.
I got his vibe. I get it.
You know, I mean, people that are religious and they want to follow it, you know, they want to, you know, want to, like, be in on God's bad side. Another way to avoid premarital sex is, you know, another way, just don't get married.
That just blew my mind.
You threw me off.
Y'all ain't ready for that one, but it's okay.
You're onto something.
I know. Another cheese for you guys really quick. So I don't know if you guys have kids or not, but as the holidays are coming up, would you consider actually renting instead of buying toys? So there is this new thing that these services are allowing to give your kids new exciting toys, maybe even more expensive toys that you probably wouldn't be able to afford.
PSI?
Something like that. But now you can rent them and at much cheaper costs, you know, especially with kids being like, kids get tired of things right away. They want the next thing. So is this genius or is this a crazy idea? What you think over there, Juan?
I don't know. I got kids. They'll get pissed. Don't take my toys.
It's How old
true.
Are they?
It's true.
I got a 17-year-old, a 15-year-old, and a 10-year-old. They'll throw a fit. Yeah, the 10-year-old won't have it.
Spoiled.
Hey, Dad, where's my toy?
Where'd it go? Hey, man.
What do you mean you got to take it back?
Yeah. What do you mean we're only borrowing us?
I connected with this toy, goddammit.
No, you know what? I have a 15-year-old and I have an 11, soon-to-be 12-year-old. And maybe it's my OCD and the low-key germaphobe in me would be like, I don't like borrowing shit. You know, like, I'm not... Like, I don't know. And it's not like that I wasn't raised with, like, hand-me-downs because I'm the youngest of five, you know? So we always borrowed our sibling shit. But, like, I don't know. That's kind of like a weird concept for me. But if I were in a different state of mind, I feel like, yeah, I would be about it. You know what I mean? I guess it just depends, like, economically where you are and, you know, if that makes sense for you monetarily as well, you know? Like, some people... that is a great idea. It's, you know, money wise, you know, that's a smart ass fucking thing to think about.
I think it also works for like younger kids who do get really tired of things. Yeah. Right away. They're like, oh, I'm tired of these Legos. You know, they're onto the dinosaurs or they're onto something else. You know?
Yeah. So. Because I've donated a shit ton of things.
Right. Like,
you know, and whomever received them, I'm sure were very happy to receive them.
True. Well, those are just some ideas for y'all. I hope you guys enjoyed the chisme. I had to make them short and quick because I really want to get into this movie right now. Yeah. But that is the chisme for tonight. It's gonna... I don't know if you can hear it.
I can't hear it, but I can already feel it, you know? It's un escándalo. Hey. That song always gets me when
The guest Latino, all the Latinos. You see them? You see them? Anytime.
I'm going to go wash the dishes right now.
It's just.
I'm going to limpiar la casa.
That's how you know you're raised right.
Right. Exactly. All right. If you guys are just tuning in, we have the cast and the director of The Devil's Ring with us, you guys. Let's give him some love. I'm so excited to have him here. So let's just jump into it. First off, before we jump into the film, I got to know more about the director of Juan Salas. Tell me your story. How did you get into film?
Well, first, I used to do music videos first in Texas. Back in Texas, I started off with Bun B. I got to work with Rick Ross.
A lot
of different artists. So I started with music videos. Now, I kind of wanted to do my own thing. So I started to do independent movies and then kind of just started to work my way from there. It's more of a trial and error thing. But this recent film, I think we kind of lucked out so far with the reaction. But that's how I made my transition into film.
Dope. So what was your first music video that you ever worked on?
Oh, you know what? It was actually Smooth Vegas video with Lil Flip.
Really?
Yeah, Vega. Yeah.
Shout out to Smooth.
Joyride. That was my first video. I got to meet Lil Flip. And, you know, shout out to Vega. You know, that was my first little, you know, video. And then, you know, just went from there.
That's dope. So you and Smooth actually have some history.
Yeah. We're actually from the same hometown, Fort Worth, Funky Town, you know, back in Texas. Yeah, shout out to Funk.
That's dope. So did you go to school for this or you just got into it?
I ended up going to the Art Institute of Dallas for several years and doing film school and living at the dorms and stuff for like forever.
Rough life.
Yeah, and then that's what started doing the music videos and stuff. So I did go to school for it, for sure.
So it's something you've always wanted to get into is...
Yeah. You know, I was kind of back in my mind. I was like, okay, let me just go try it out.
Right. Whatever. Are you an 80s baby too?
I was born in 87.
Okay. Because I'm saying like, because I grew up loving music videos. I don't know if you guys...
Hell yeah, Williams.
Waiting for 106 in Park.
Yeah.
106 in Park. The countdown. Yeah. I was on 106 in Park for like, I think the last year.
Really?
Well, it was a song called Walk Around the Club, Fuck Everybody. I don't know if you heard of that one. Did that video too. That's from Dallas.
Hold on. I just learned some. Hold on. That was you, Quinn?
Yeah, I shot the video. God. Yeah. We're in Atlanta with Collie Park.
Come on, man.
Yeah.
That is amazing because you know what? I'm glad you made that connection because it's true. Because I feel like if you were like an 80s or 90s baby, you grew up on
music videos.
Yeah. Like the songs wouldn't even come out until the fucking music.
Oh yeah, it was like an event. Every time music videos came out,
and it was all theatrical. Like it was.
Yeah, it was Hype Williams. Yeah, Hype Williams. Yeah. Like Boomtown.
I mean, you had even big time directors, you know, film directors actually directing music videos because of. That's how big they were, how important they were. Spike Lee, you know, you name it. Absolutely.
So, we for sure definitely grew up on music videos. And I think like at one point I even wanted to make music videos. That's why I was saying, because I relate to you on that. Right. Because nowadays, I mean, every time you come to my place, I have the music videos that YouTube playing on the back. And people will sit there like, yo, I've never seen the music video to this song. Like nobody watches music videos now. And I'm like, maybe it's I need to bring it back. Maybe I need to create something here on my TV.
You know you should. There's a lot of music videos.
That's a good idea.
When I play it on my house, people will sit there and watch it. Yeah. They're drinking or smoking. They're just there and they're like locked in.
Yeah.
But nobody really goes to look for it. So it's kind of like if you create it, if you build it, they'll come. There's something there that's missing.
Definitely.
You know what I mean? Right. Have you seen any of the Bad Bunny music videos?
I have.
Okay.
Badass.
You said no.
You know what? I love Bad Bunny because I feel like he brings a sense of creativity.
Yeah. Artistic. Music video he did with Julieta Venegas, Lo Siento.
Oh my God, that's beautiful.
I love that one. Yeah. But that's so dope. And I love that you transition into bigger things like movies now. Yeah. That your platform is just huge now, giving opportunities to, you know, Linda and to Alex like that to. I love it. I love that you have like all Latino cast on there. That was I'm assuming that mostly everybody on there was Latino.
Mostly.
Yeah. That's dope.
To me, what I saw was Latinx. Like,
yeah,
Latinos
definitely.
On there,
that's what we're trying to showcase. We wanted to show the culture in a better light. I mean, look at our recent productions. I haven't seen one other than maybe Lowrider and then Narcos that just came out. There's not really a good representation that we want to see like that. And that's what I felt that was missing. We wanted to see our culture displayed correctly other than just Narcos. That was the best I've ever seen a production value. Other than like, okay, Lowriders that came out a while back, Blood In, Blood Out a long time ago. We wanted to bring something current and something they haven't seen. You haven't seen a Latino with braids. In any other movie, you might see a bald guy, but you won't see someone swagged out.
Yeah,
we're always like that. You know, people are heavily influenced by our culture, but they have yet to really see us display it effortlessly. But kind of like Alex,
I gotta ask you, speaking of Latinidad, what are your nationalities?
I'm Mexican.
Okay.
You know, I was born in Texas, but
We're Mexican. I get it. All you too, you guys.
And I'm Mexican to the motherfucking core. Guys.
Yeah.
Let it be known.
Where were you born?
What Los part of Angeles. Mexico?
LA.
Hey, LA is Mexico.
No, but that's true.
Hey, you're right about that.
What part of Mexico are your parents from?
Well, my mom is from Laredo. My dad is from Chihuahua.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And you, Alex?
My mom's from Durango, Mexico. And my dad's from Colima, Mexico.
My dad's from Durango.
I was just going to say, you're like a very Durango.
I'm
okay.
I'm okay.
And you? What about you,
Linda? I was born in Mexico. I'm from Chihuahua, Mexico.
What?
And I was raised back and forth between Dallas and Chihuahua.
You do not sound like you were born in Mexico. That's dope. I say that because I was born in Honduras. I'm Central American.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, most people see me and don't think I'm Latina, you know, and like, until they hear me speak Spanish and they're like, oh shit, this black girl can talk. I'm like, no.
Or Pacific Islander.
I'm Latina.
Yeah. I thought she was Pacific Islander. I'm like, okay. But no, she surprised me too with that. I was like, you speak Spanish, girl?
I talk Spanish.
Well, no, this is before I met you.
She speaks it better than you.
Yeah, for real.
My mom does.
Pocha. Yeah, that's so good though. Like, I love that. So I love that the film that portrays that, like all the Latinos on there. And you're right, like just modernize it in
there's
a way.
There's a variety. We're not all bald.
Thank you. And no shade to that because there are a lot of Latinos. I got some cousins and primos that are bald headed, tatted up, but not every Latino looks like that. So I love that you made the diversity into that, like on your film. I appreciate that.
You're right, because you know what? You don't see a lot of films or, you know, I mean, other than the Netflix special Hentified. Have you guys, you know, I love that show. I think it's fucking dope.
That's a good show.
You know, and you want to see more films out there that are giving the proper and actual representation of who we are as Latinos.
Right.
You know? Strong as Latinos. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
We got shit.
So let's go ahead and get into your latest film, because it's not your only film, right?
No,
you have like 7 or 8 other films under your belt.
1, 2, 3. It's my fourth, but out of my fifth.
Dang,
okay.
This is the fourth.
Because I saw you had an animated one too, right? Naranja or something like that.
That was like an animation.
But those count because you can't. Yeah. Even if it's not what you wanted to see, it's where you started. Everybody got to start somewhere.
Yeah.
So if you listen to my first episode, my voice was shaking. I was messing up. Like, now it's like whatever, but it's literally, you got to start somewhere, and that's your history. That's your timeline.
But you know what? I think it got me ready for this movie. I'm glad, you know, it's always trial and error in filmmaking, and it got me ready for this. Alex was actually my last movie, which we won awards for, but that was his first role, and it got us ready for this.
Mm-hmm.
And it couldn't have went any better, I think.
Yeah. That's so talk about that. How you guys first met and how you guys connected for the second
I'll
film.
I'll let Alex tell it. Alex, tell how I met you.
Your smile is telling me it's crazy.
Alex is like, let me talk.
Okay, hey, I'm gonna try to make this as fast as I can.
Are you being shy right now, Alex?
No, no, not at all. Not at all. Nah, this is good vibes. I love it. Thank you for having us, first of all, man. I really appreciate it. But yeah, so long story short, if I can make it short, goddammit, I wish I had a whole fucking 2 hours because I can't. But anyways, he had hit me up for a project. He had a horror film in mind. And at that time, the way that he found me, I was doing Facebook videos, skits and shit. This is back like 6-7 years ago before everybody wanted to do them.
Like Vine, so, yeah, Vine time?
Yeah. So in Dallas, like I was the one that was moving that, you know what I mean? And that agenda. So I was like, and he hit me up and he's like, hey, man, I have a small role for you, you know, for acting. And that's what I wanted. That was my main goal, was for somebody to basically find me and discover me type deal. You know what I mean? And he hit me up and I was like, cool. And then like a couple weeks later, I end up getting hemmed up. So, and then I get out and then I hit him up again. And I'm like, hey, Juan, like I'm out now, bro. Like, what's up? I want to work. And so he's like, hey, man, I have a project. Let's do it. That's when I got into the Wolfcatcher with him. And I think from there, the relationship and the bond just grew. And I'm here now. So I want to give a shout out to Juan, man. I appreciate it because he believed in me. And this is what it's about, you know?
I love that. That's dope. And what were you going to say?
Yeah, that's before I threw him into the ring. Yeah. We didn't know what we signed up for. With that. I'll get into that in a minute. But yeah.
Sink or swim, baby. Sink or swim.
So you just
hey, but I was ready for it all, though.
Yeah, he was. Yeah,
you were hungry for it. Hell, so you were putting in the work.
Oh,
before we had influencers, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Before we had influencers, there was Vine, there was Facebook, all of that. So, hey, shout out to you for that, for hustling and seeing the vision before it was even the vision for people.
Right, right.
So that's really dope. But we do have people in the comments.
I see them.
We got Jack Rain Comedy. That says so Jack funny. Rain. I forgot. It must have been something we were saying.
Carol Mommy. I play videos still, but they aren't the same.
Yeah, I'm telling you, we got to bring the hype back around the music videos for sure, for sure. All right, well, what can people, so people haven't seen the movie The Devil's Ring, obviously, because it just came out. What can you tell the people that to expect from this film?
Here's what it's about. It stars Damien Chopper Miklo from Blood In, Blood Out.
That's dope.
The movie is a boxing film. The movie's about a young boxer who gets involved with a sinister promoter played by Damien Chopper. The deal goes wrong, so he has to find the help of a retired champion played by Al Diaz to basically, it's a literal fight for his soul from the devil himself. That's what I can say, but it's definitely a movie about family. There's many themes and elements in it, and it is a boxing film. So with the whole, it displays a whole, you know, Latin culture. We actually shot at El Pino, you know, from Blood In, Blood Out. We shot there. We're heavily influenced by that. Magic is in the movie. Victor Rivers, he was also in Blood In, Blood Out. He's in the movie as well. So we are heavily influenced by Blood In, Blood Out. And I wanted to, you know, show that in a way, like touch on that.
I have a question. Go for it. How did you cast Miklo?
Miklo?
Yeah.
Man, I was about to do a whole other movie and an opportunity came across to work with him. So I'm like, I had this script laying around. I'm like, let me just send it to him. He's going to say no, whatever. But let me take a chance.
Yeah.
It took me a while to send that text.
You missed 100% of the shots you don't take.
I was like, you know what? It's gone, whatever. I just sent it, like, whatever, fuck it. 20 minutes later, 30 minutes later, his manager hits me back. He's like, okay, just send me the script. We'll see it. We'll just look at it. Mm-hmm. Well, he'll look at it first. So I sent it. He liked it. And then I didn't hear nothing for 4 or 5 days. And I get a phone call and a voicemail. And it's Damien Chopper.
Damn.
He leaves a message. He goes, hey, man, I love your writing. I want to do it. Call me. And that was from there. It just took off.
Jeez.
Yeah. So that's how Damien got involved. That's awesome. I was just like, holy shit. And then I kept that recording, that voicemail. I was probably all I'm going to get. He's never going to call me again.
It's over. Evidence later.
And I was like, hold on. You already signed up. You already signed up. So yeah, when that happened, it was surreal and it was crazy. He was the first biggest actor I've ever had in a movie.
Absolutely,
movie. Yeah. So, like I said, I was 4 months into a whole other movie. I just had a chance to, like, I came across him. So it was like, it was full speed. And then, you know, things went from there.
Him being an actor in, like, the industry for so long, did you learn anything? Did you ask any questions?
Man, hell yeah.
I would hope so,
I said, hey, bro, how long is Blood In, Blood Out? Because there was a picture with Paco dancing. That wasn't in the movie, so I asked him about
brain right quick.
Yeah, I want to know that. I've been thinking that since I was like 10. I had that movie since I was 10. That's my chance. Paco, that is not in there. And he was like, it's a 5-hour movie.
Fuck.
And he says it exists. It's out there. It exists. Yeah. And they just don't know what to do with it, whatever. So I was like, so that's where that picture came from. So I found that out. And no,
they should have broken up like The Godfather into pieces.
I think they should. Right? They should re-release it. I wish they would. That you know what? It's not even on. That. It's not on Netflix. It's nowhere digitally.
Nowhere.
You have to buy it. Like that's a whole conversation. But yeah, having him involved was amazing and the work.
That's dope.
He's Latino royalty, right?
He is. I tell everybody, Blood is like the Bible everywhere. So
have you been to Los Cinco Puntos?
I went to the Pilpino, though. That's the only
one. You know why I'm asking? Because my softball team, the co-ed team that I play for, we have a really good relationship with Los Cinco Puntos.
Oh, wow.
And we're sponsored by them.
That's dope.
So we are softball team's name is LCP for Los Cinco Puntos. I always put that out there. So when she told me about this, whole connection with Blood In, Blood Out and all the connection, I was like, dude, that's fucking dope.
We almost had more of the actors in it too, but by the time we were wrapping it, the rest found out. Yeah. I was like,
you need to take a trip
for the sequel.
You need to take a trip to Los Cinco Puntos.
We will.
Have to.
That'd be dope. So and Linda, how did you get connected to the film?
I was supposed to be a flashback. So
really?
You're not a flashback, you're a main back.
Ended up completely changing my role. Juan reached out to me to do a flashback scene. I show up, we do the flashback scene, and then maybe a month later, he reaches back out to me again. He's like, actually, I want to have you as Nico's wife, as Damien Chapa's wife. I was like, okay. So one scene turned into maybe a couple of more scenes. That's how I got in.
Hey, that's dope. But how'd you guys connect to meet?
We were just casting. And she's probably the most working model in Dallas right now. And I think the hottest cast. And that's Linda.
Hey, that's right.
I try my best to work hard.
So it's safe to say that everybody on the cast is from Dallas.
Yeah, they're the best in Dallas. I had to get the best.
I love that, though.
Throughout, and we got the best representation that we could find.
Why was that important for you to keep people from Dallas in the film?
Well, we casted the best for the most part. But we casted from everywhere. There's actors from all over. But it was important to bring my hometown into it and bring it home at the end of the day. But it's a broader story than that. It's not just about where we're from, but where we're going.
No, but I'm asking you as far as a director, because I really do love that about you.
Yeah.
The fact that, yes, you're coming up. You could easily go up and hit up people in L.A. because there's a bunch of actors in L.A.
Yeah, yeah. He's already on it.
Hey, shout out to, what's his name, Jake?
Jack Rain. Yeah, he has a space movie coming out. Talking about it.
He's like, hey, here I am. I'm one of those. Yeah.
But I feel it. And the fact that you gave so much support and love to the people within your community, I have a lot of respect for that, because, I love my city. I love L.A. If I, when I make it, I'm bringing my people with me, around, I really respect that. And, as a director, I understand, that you can really go anywhere with it, but you decided to stay within your hometown.
Appreciate that.
So that's dope. You guys putting Dallas on the map over here.
I love Dallas.
One of my best friends lives in Dallas.
Oh man.
Yeah, we've been to Dallas different times, not together, Arlington, but we had so much fun.
Right.
Y'all can fucking party in Dallas.
Party in Dallas. Hit me when y'all go out there.
For the Dodger playoff game, and I was like,
okay,
one of my best friends in Arlington, Dallas.
Let's not get into the Astro Dodgers right now, because that's a little too painful right now. I really like them right now. And y'all Astros are on another level. So I'm not basing the Astros on you guys. I'm going to say that. I'm going to keep it that. You going to say something?
Because we ain't Astros over here, baby. We over here Texas Rangers.
Texas Rangers.
That's Houston. Like,
thank you.
Hey, but shout out to Houston, though. Much love.
Yeah,
much love to Houston.
I love you guys even more for saying that shit. Because the Dodgers don't fuck with the Astros.
They do not.
No, motherfucking no. If you guys watch sports, do you know why? You know why? Because Astros cheated.
Oh,
they cheated. They were
baseball. You know.
So we're big baseball fans. We play softball during the week too, but we're big Dodger fans. And so just to kind of update you, Linda, the Astros were caught cheating, reading the opposite pitcher's signs.
Oh wow! What happened, Houston?
Right. So that's why a lot of fans. Who else don't like them? I think the Yankees don't like them. Everybody don't like them. So they're on the shit list right now. So that's why I'm glad you guys are not Astro fans. So I'm not gonna hold that on y'all. But so let's get into more about it. Like, to talk about the film. So what is something that you want, like, also like the fans and people to know about this film? Like, what went into it?
Well, one thing for sure is go into it. The being a boxer is not easy. It's not. It's a lot of training. And when me and Alex signed up, we had an idea of what we're getting into.
I'm so glad you said that. We have Carol Mommy. She asked, "Yeah, I'm curious if they had any boxing background before the film."
Oh, well, tell you what. No, look, he's an actor, but we got the real life 2-time world champion Polly Ayala from Fort Worth
to
give us a glimpse of what it's about. So he trained Alex for 2 weeks, and it was crazy, brutal. It was crazy. Not only that, but we put Alex in the ring with real boxers. This is an independent movie. There's no special effects like Creed and all that.
Yeah.
Like, these are real punches being thrown. He could get knocked out.
Oh, my God.
And he was up for it. So Polly trained him just a glimpse, and it was insane.
Did you guys have medical on standby?
Shit, no. This is an independent. Alex, come on, bro. Just duck it, bro.
911 on speed dial.
There you go. He got it. He took a shot. Come on, back in there. No, I'm just kidding. That's not true.
Hey, one thing about Mexicans, man, we never back down. You know?
Right.
We step up to the plate.
Sure.
That's right.
No pun intended to baseball.
Hey, I like that.
But
so tell me about that. Since you were really taking these hits, like, did one of them really kind of take you out?
Oh, there's been some that possibly connected.
Shit, man.
But you know what? Like, what helped me, like, more than anything, was that, like, I used to fight. You know what I'm saying? I grew up in the streets. You know, I grew up fighting and, you know what I'm saying, getting into little brawls and shit. So this was easy for me to take. That's why when Juan told me about it, I was like, man, I'm with it. Let's go. I'm with the shit. Told me, like, let's get it.
Right.
And we did. And I'm glad it turned out the way it did, man. Devil's Ring, shout out, man. It's available now.
For real.
You know, I was reading Will Smith's, well, I listened to his podcast of his, his book, the recent book that he just put out.
Oh, yeah.
And he was talking about when he was filming Ali and the training that, you know, how intense it was to not only try to portray Ali, but really just become him, you know, and how he physically had to put all in the work, right? And it's like the most challenging thing that you ever have to do as a, you know, method actor.
Right.
How do you feel that, like, now? Has it affected you as an actor? Like, has that stayed with you? Is that going to carry on with you?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Having to portray someone that, you know, you're not, it's not who you were before.
Right. And to answer your question, the best way that I can, it does kind of settle in a way, as far as, you know, whenever you're, you know, as an actor, you try your best to portray somebody, right? You try to portray a character. You try to humanize it the best way possible. And with me, I want to feel every emotion. Like, it's not, I don't just want the audience to feel the emotion. I don't want to just convey it to them, but I want to convey it to myself, because that's the best way that I can sell it. And that's, like, that's bottom line. Like, I want to feel what the audience feels.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So, and whatever that means, like, I'm gonna go there. You know what I'm saying? And it helped, like, enormously. Moving forward now, that's all I want to do is method acting. You know what I mean? I want to feel it. Everything that I do, I want to know what that feels like. And I want to, like, literally feel that. You know what I'm saying? And hopefully, because I know it's going to happen, I'm going to be able to convey that to my audience in future films.
I love that.
Kudos to you, man.
You did a phenomenal job in this film. I got to give you your flowers too. Like, I, you know, you, the fact that I learned that you didn't have nothing to do with boxing, mm-hmm. and you it looked like you did. You looked like you really put into it. You were taking some hits, yeah. and you know, I gotta give you kudos from just knowing your story of how you kind of started, how you connected with Juan, and where you are now. Like, you're only gonna get better from here now. Like, you're only going higher. That's it. You know what I mean?
Hey,
like,
you got more. Thank you, Jackie. Appreciate that. For real, man.
No, I love this dynamic that you guys have. I love how you guys support each other. You cheer each other on. I love that, you know, and you got to keep remembering that and take that to the top. No matter how high you go, always keep taking each other to the top. So that's dope. So talk about any future projects you got going on.
Yeah, so look, right now, the Devil's Ring is out right now on all digital platforms, Vudu, iTunes. Right now, we're almost done filming a horror film in L.A. called House of Dolls. It stars my friend Jack Rain.
Shout out to Jack Rain.
From L.A., it stars Taylor Cox, Alicia Underwood. We got Emma Lopez in the movie. We got Heidi in the movie as well. She's in it as well. And we're also working on a space movie starring Jack Rain, an untitled one. Mm. Filming in L.A. next February.
Jack Rain is busy.
We're shooting a pilot. It's a space movie in L.A. So we're excited about that. That's what I'm working on right now.
Does it take place in L.A.?
It takes place in the galaxy.
Oh, okay.
Crazy stuff. We got a spaceship in L.A. ready to film.
I feel you.
Yeah, and so shout out to Jack.
We'll have to bring Jack back on. We'll talk about that.
They also have projects coming up too. Yeah. Alex has a cop movie coming up after this. We can't give away too much, but take it down a little bit. You can't tell him your co-star.
Okay.
Tell him. We want the juice.
Okay, so check it out, man. One thing that I've always wanted to do, and I've always told myself, if I make it and when I make it as an actor, I want to show range. I don't want to be typecast. I don't want to just be a thug. I don't want to be known for this, for that. Yes. I can do it all. You know what I mean? If you need me to be Italiano, I could be Italiano. If you need me to be whatever you want me to be, I can do it. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Like, I'm up for the challenge, baby. Like, anything. And if you want me to be a cop, hey, Officer Luna, it is.
Yeah.
I love it. You're right, though, because Latinos do get typecasted.
And you know,
and it's tough to like try to break that.
Yeah, and I'm trying to stay away from that as much as possible.
Good for you.
Who is the is it his name is Daniel Trejo? No, what's his first name?
Carlos?
No, the Trejo, tattoo guy.
Daniel.
I call him Daniel.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Danny Trejo. So I was watching an interview with him, and he said when he first got started, like, this girl from straight out of college, he's like journalist student. She came up to him and was like, aren't you tired of always being typecasted as the angry Latino, tatted up, and, you know, mean guy in the film? And he was like, I am the mean, tatted Latino guy. That's who I am. So why would I get mad about that? But, you know, at the end of the day, you just got to follow your range. And honestly, he's never really played anything else other than that. But I respect what you're saying, like, because we do fall out of untimed stereotypes. If that's you, that's cool. If you want to play stereotypes, that's fine.
And I'm about to break that barrier. I'm about to break that whole damn shebang.
Right.
Whatever
right.
it is, man.
Right, for
people,
sure.
Some people are comfortable being in that.
I mean, J-Lo started playing maids. She was playing the freaking housekeeper. She was doing all the Latino roles, you know. But then she got transitioned to the Italian one. So you didn't know if she was, you know, Latina or Italian or what. Like the wedding planner. It was the wedding planner. It was one of those that she was just like, you didn't know if she was white or what in that film.
Right, right. And that's what you want to do.
Not with that booty.
Yeah.
right.
But yeah, for sure, man.
I got to ask you guys, speaking of J-Lo, how did you guys feel about her playing Selena, who is a big Texas legend? You know what I mean? How do you guys feel about that?
I mean, that's
honest truth. No, because
she played her? Like in the movie? You talking about the movie?
Yeah. Selena. Yeah.
That's how she got her breakthrough.
Selena looks excited.
You nailed that one.
Okay. Well, I won't push
more into that. Honestly, a lot of people weren't happy about it in Texas. Personally, I think she did a great job. I can't imagine anybody else.
I was too young when that came. I don't think I even
care. I love that movie. I've watched it. I don't know how many times.
It depends on how old you are.
Yeah.
You were in the first, second grade, I think, when it came out.
Probably. I was like, wow.
Yeah. But even now as an adult, now as a filmmaker.
I love it more.
In the industry. Like having J-Lo, like, because Selena is like a big.
I love it more. I don't think, I mean, I'm just talking out loud here, but the, like the TV show, it had nothing on the movie, like at all. I watch it now, and it's more like heartbreaking than when I was a kid. Because it's like someone from Texas that tried to make it.
Was making it.
Oh my God, the Chris and all that. The Netflix thing didn't even touch that. Like that.
Okay, I want to say something now that we're touching on Selena. I want to admit something, but it's between us, right?
All right, right here. Just us.
Okay, so check it out.
All of us at the radio station.
Third grade. Selena had just passed. Rest in peace, Selena, always. And we did a performance because they were trying to do like some just talent, you know what I'm saying? Like a little within the class or whatever, what you could do. And so they put us up in groups. They assigned us in groups of three. And we performed Dreaming of You. And I'm never going to forget it.
Hey, did you
cry? Hey, shout out Dora. I still remember your name. I don't know your last name, but you were in my class.
Shout out to Dora.
Because she played Selena and I was in the background.
Swimming, Dora. I mean.
Hey, that's what started this whole performance thing, you know?
Yeah, I feel it.
Go ahead, Dora. Get your little shout out.
Well, I love that you guys were able to stop by and talk about the film. It is a great, you said it's available on all platforms. So make sure you guys support, you know what I mean? You want to see more Latino directors? Well, you got to support them so they keep making it up and keep making more films.
Yes.
So make sure you watch them. Pay that, how much is it? $10, $12, $15,
$20? It's just like $10. Then. Man, we need LA behind us too. You know, we did this for y'all too. We came all the way out here to film it with Miklo and all that. So we appreciate everyone's support.
I love it, man. Anytime I see my people doing things like this, you know, like I love it. So, you know, you got my support.
Thank you so much.
And I really enjoyed the film.
Thank
so for
you.
Sure.
Oh,
I do got to ask, though, because we're all Latinos. No, we're knowing that. When you tell your family you're going to get into certain industry, you know, like. They don't always understand because
hell
we come.
No, don't.
So,
you want to direct what?
You
want to get into radio? Tortas
loco?
Run around.
How has your family support been from starting until now?
¿Cómo haces dinero?
Well, they were always supportive. If anything, like other people in general, coming from the hood, hey, I'm gonna go make movies. You crazy,
right?
Like I was crazy for a few years. Now it's like, hey, can I get a ticket to
movie, right?
Bro? Sorry, bro, it's sold out.
Right,
get on iTunes.
Right, facts.
But you can purchase.
Shout out to my bros.
You guys are funny.
That's
we got to go on to our next segment of the night, and it's going to be our game segment, you guys. We're going to go ahead and put these crazy kids into the hot seat. I don't know if they're ready. Are you guys ready?
Man, what's Annie? Go ahead.
Come on.
Oh, shit.
I kind of gave him some sample questions, so we'll see
Are you pre-game them? You gave me a little pre-game?
I gave him a pre-game, just so I know, because I didn't want to scare them too much. We're going to go ahead and...
Never scared. Come on, man.
Okay. All right, you guys. It is game time with our special guests. And we're going to put them in the hot seat. So we're just going to ask them questions and they have to answer them quickly. Okay. So that's how the game is played. I just say something and you have to answer it quickly. So like a first example, like I gave you on off air, like a beach or mountains, Juan.
What?
Beach or mountains?
What's that?
No, come on.
What is that?
The beach or mountains?
Oh, the beach.
Beach.
Your mountains.
This is gonna take long. I thought he was kidding, but no, he was real.
He's
like, what?
What is that?
The beach
or a mountain?
Or a mountain.
You have to enunciate it.
And that was an easy one.
Enunciate for Juan over here.
I got you.
What was that? Linda, okay. So she can show the guys how to start it.
Yeah. Lady's got to show them how to do it, you know.
All right, I'll show you. Tequila shots or micheladas?
Oh, tequila shots.
Hey! Hey!
Yeah, tequila shots. You should have tequila.
Tequila shots. All day.
We got no tequila?
No, we didn't. I just got them wine. I know. All right. Another one is your favorite TV show, Alex?
TV show. God damn it.
Just your favorite TV show. Whatever comes to mind.
Fuck, I don't have. Yeah, I don't have a favorite TV show. Yeah, I don't watch.
Not even from the your past, your childhood.
Yeah, childhood, growing up.
Sex in the City.
Full House.
Hey! You just told your age.
I'm gonna ask all of you this: what is your go-to snack when you go to the movies?
Popcorn.
Palomitas. Hot Cheetos or Takis?
Hot Cheetos.
Hey, okay.
I think it's the new kids that are about Takis. Yeah. Like, if you're like 80s, 90s, 2000s.
Yeah, I don't get that. I don't get
they're just salty for
right?
me.
Yeah.
I can't do that.
Too salty.
Yeah.
A little bit of limon, tapatio.
Favorite foods, you guys. Favorite foods.
Tacos.
Tacos, pizza. Oh, what kind of tacos, Linda?
Tacos de birria. Honestly, all types of tacos. I can make anything into a taco.
Yeah, that's true. Latinos can definitely do that for sure. What about you? What kind of tacos?
Barbacoa.
Oh, okay. I like tacos de lengua.
Lengua.
Sushi.
Sushi.
I wonder why.
I wonder why.
I know why.
Celebrity crush.
Ooh, Edwin Cass from Grupo Firme.
Oh. Okay.
Rihanna.
She's a bad B.
Rihanna can get it.
Amelia Clark from Game of Thrones.
Oh my God, I love her.
Me too.
Okay.
Me too. I mean, I'm not gay, but I love her.
This is for the fellas. Boxers or briefs?
Hey, Alex is like Speedo.
Tanga.
Okay. Do we got pictures?
I fuck with the briefs. Yeah.
Even as a boxer?
Get it. Oh my God. Hey, shout out to Carol Mommy. She says she's gonna watch it. She's gonna watch your film.
His whole family wants to be in the movies.
She sure did say that. It's okay.
Hey, she said earlier, aguantando
putazos el vato. That's right. Yeah. He sure did. Hey, watch the film, you're gonna see these hits. All right, I got some more questions for you guys. Is there an ex you would take back?
No.
Fuck no.
Damn.
Linda said no.
Yeah. Okay, guys. No. Drake, all of you. Drake or Kanye?
Drake.
Drake.
Okay. This is for the fellas. Three favorite body parts on a woman.
Goddamn, tits, ass, and a goddamn panooch.
I'm gonna go with Alex.
I went full Texan on that one.
I'll go with Alex.
That. Yeah, we call that the panooch.
Panooch.
All right, dead.
Linda, what about you? What's your favorite body? Three favorite body parts about men on the men.
I like their smile.
Okay.
Their eyes.
Okay.
What else? They have to have nice legs.
Okay. Okay.
Huh? Not the D.
I mean, that too. Okay, I'll take the bag.
Her favorite body part. Not yours, Joe.
Okay, my bad.
Talking about some earlobes over here.
Hey, you know what?
That's a difference.
Let me rub on your earlobes. How big are them earlobes?
How old were you guys when you had your first kiss?
I was in fifth grade.
Okay.
I was 7.
Shut up, 7? Okay.
Whatever grade that was. Yeah,
that's like a third grader.
Fifth, sixth grade. See, I don't count the one like around kindergarten. I don't count that one. But so I was a late. I didn't have my first kiss till I was 18. So I was a late bloomer.
You're talking about like lengua y todo.
Todo. Yeah.
Okay. Hold on, man. 8.
He went from 7 to 8.
In that case, mine was probably middle school.
Okay.
Sure. Like a makeout session. Yeah.
What's your favorite curse word, you guys? Your favorite curse word to say?
Thank you. Fuck.
He elongated that one. Yeah, like,
what about you, Alex? Okay, what are your biggest fear, you guys?
Damn, you went deep on that one.
I know.
Have to take a deep
hold
breath.
On.
Deep breath, like, guys.
I'm already high as it is, so I can't be too high.
I'm scared of heights.
Me too. Yeah. For sure. Mm. But what's crazy, I still want to jump out of an airplane.
Yeah, I can't roller coasters
for some fucking reason.
Just to say that you've done it, right?
Yeah. I'm scared of heights.
I feel like it'll help me.
Just do it.
I like flying. I'm scared of heights, but I still want to jump out of a fucking plane.
Yeah.
Like weird, right?
Yeah. Who is the most famous person you have in your phone?
Shit.
Can't disclose
Jamie
that.
And Chapo.
Ah, you can't Jamie disclose Chapo. That? He said Rihanna.
Juan Salas. Ah!
I love that.
You're my next movie, bro. You're my next movie, bro.
Just Tequiles.
Okay.
I thought she said Chilaquiles. Hold on, man. That's not even a person.
No, just Tequiles.
Okay, okay. What's your guilty pleasure, you guys?
Pizza.
Okay.
Masturbating.
Masturbating. It better not be in public.
Un puñetón.
Oh my God. Okay, okay. Where's the craziest place you've all had sex? Craziest place. Come on, I want to hear the craziest ones. Mm-hmm. Alex, I know you got some crazy spots.
Alex is thinking, like, what is
what which makes one? Say that?
That smile on your face.
Bathroom stall isn't crazy enough.
Balconies, rooftops, taxis, Uber.
Everybody's in a car. That's
inside a church.
Wow.
Good job, man.
While the church was going.
No.
And the back, in the wherever they were lighting the candles, the veladoras.
What?
God damn it.
Oh my God.
I'm going to arrest you.
How did you
pay? Ay Dios, por favor, perdóname.
Giving Virgin Mary her roses. No, no más.
Even
no
I'm mames. Offended. And I'm not even like Catholic like that.
Okay, mine was on a rooftop.
Had a girl.
Rooftop outside. And
okay.
We got caught, but.
Oh, that you did get caught.
You got caught?
Yeah, we got caught. We were like, sorry. I was like,
oh, you didn't get caught by the cops though.
Oh,
that's
yeah,
good.
No, not the cops.
Did you guys hear about the couple that they were in the back of a police car and the girl started giving him head?
Oh, no way.
Yeah. What? Yeah.
Trying to get out of that ticket.
So, no, not the cop. She was giving her boyfriend head in the backseat of the cop car.
Oh, so they were both getting arrested.
So, what happened was, I think his license was suspended. So, the cop was nice enough to give them a ride to the nearest gas station so that they can get picked up because he wasn't going to allow them to drive anymore. But he wasn't going to give them a ticket, nothing like that. He wasn't even going to arrest them. So, he's like, all right, you guys get in my car. They're in the backseat of the car. He's driving them to the gas station. And all of a sudden, she starts giving him head in the back.
Shut the fuck up.
Yeah. And he starts recording it, the boyfriend. So the cop ended up arresting both of them after that. Yeah. I'm like, you guys are idiots.
Lucky bastard.
Yeah, they can say they had sex in a cop car.
Probably you're like, that was like on their kink list. Like,
for sure. Hey,
suck my dick in the back of a, you know, cop car. Check.
So I know it's real.
World star.
She's a writer or die.
Do you guys have a hall pass? A celebrity hall pass? Mm. Because from all of you guys, who are you guys in relationships? Who's in a relationship? Who's married? Single?
I'm single.
Single.
Hey, girl.
I'm in a relationship.
Okay.
I'm in a relationship.
Okay, okay. Do you guys have hall passes?
I don't think so. She'd probably shoot me.
Yeah, hey, not at all.
I don't think so.
She's listening to us right now as we speak.
Look, I just got a text.
Shout out to my baby, Cindy. I love you, baby.
You have not made it enough yet. You got to keep going, buddy.
No, because
you have a hall pass.
Right.
No, but I'm saying if you have a hall pass, she has to have a hall pass. That's how it works.
It works that way.
Hey, that's not the way it works with Latinos.
Hey, I'll give you that, Alex.
I'll give you that. Yeah. But normally, hall passes, the way it works is like you have a one celebrity hall pass. So if you get the opportunity to hook up with that celebrity, you have a hall pass. There's a whole movie about it. Yeah.
That's some white shit.
Oh, okay.
There's a whole movie. Yeah, it was. Sorry, Jack. It's okay. Your kids are halfway.
Yeah,
they are. I'm just kidding.
I have a pass.
You have a pass. But shout out to my guests. They made it through the freaking hot seat. Yeah. Yeah, shout out to you guys. You guys made it through. Okay, okay, okay. Normally when I have tequila here and you guys don't answer it, I make you take shots.
No.
So luckily you guys all answered all the questions, so you didn't need any.
Right.
We're going to go into our last segment of the night, and it is our cheers and what's giving me life. Yes, that's your girl, Riri Alex. So this is where you share something you're proud of, you give yourself some love, or just what's giving you life this week. And we're going to go ahead and start off with my girl, Joe, so she can show you guys how it's done. Joe, what's giving you life, girl? What's you want to give cheers to?
You know what? You know, I coach my daughter's varsity basketball team.
I do.
And we've been fucking working hard.
You guys have. And tell them the news.
Should I?
Yes.
So our the boys and the girls varsity basketball team at our high school is sponsored by the Jordan brand.
Woo woo!
And,
and that's huge.
A few like a month ago or two, they surprised us with this whole like shootout. They took awesome pictures and it was just this big old event downtown LA. And they took like group photos, they took individual photos, and we had no idea what the photos were going to be about. Me as a parent and like part of the coaching staff, had no clue. There's a billboard on Olympic and Sawtelle with their picture on it.
What?
It's fucking dope.
I didn't know it was on those streets. Those are big streets.
That's a big street. So if you're from LA, West LA, you know Olympic and Sawtelle is like busy as shit. That's like 405 and the 10 where they meet. And my daughter's in a fucking billboard.
She's on a billboard!
Congratulations.
It's fucking dope. And you know what? She's been working really hard. She's a sophomore. And, you know, she's had really good games where she's like, she's a better shooter than I was in college, you know, high school and college. But fucking cheers. And here's my fucking,
cheers.
To my basketball team for my girls working hard. And
all of it. I love it.
So that's where my cheers is for.
Yes. All right, Juan, what about you? What do you want to give a cheers to, or what's giving you life?
I want to give a cheers to my upcoming project, House of Dolls, my space project on the way in LA. I'm going to be here smoking out the rest of the year.
Okay.
Yeah.
Bring them over to Ladies Night.
We'll
promote you guys. Rain.
We're bringing them over.
Jack in the corner over there. All right, Alex, your turn. What do you want to give cheers to, or what's giving you life right now?
Everything's giving me life. God damn, y'all are giving me life.
Oh,
I swear. Nah, it's just beautiful, man. You know, it's surreal. Something you dream about all your life, and then it's come to fruition, and you made it happen. I mean, shit. What else do you want? You know what I'm saying? That's what life's about.
I love it.
You strive, you push, and you get to where you want to be at. Fuck, man. There's nothing else that can fucking, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I agree with you, man.
That's what it is. Cheers for that.
Cheers. I love it.
And cheers to my son's birthday tomorrow, Alexander, man.
Hey, happy birthday.
December 11th.
No, it's the 12th. Tomorrow.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
No, tomorrow's the 11th.
El Día de la Virgen. Oh, no, Sunday. Alexander.
I was like, tomorrow's the 11th.
Yeah. Tomorrow's the 11th. He's excited about it. He's excited.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
That's
baby Alexander Jr., man.
Hey, how old is he going to be?
He's going to be 3.
I love that. All right, Linda, what about you? What do you want to give a cheers to? What's giving you life right now?
Man, I feel so blessed just to like be here and just so many upcoming projects. And, you know, as a model actress, you work hard.
Yeah.
And sometimes it's not seen. So whenever it's recognized, that just means a lot.
I love that.
But cheers to that. I feel super, super blessed. And cheers to my family back in Dallas.
Yeah, shout them out.
To my sister, Emily, you know, my dad, my mom's in Chihuahua. She lives out there. So, you know, she supports me all the way from out there. So
I love it.
Shout out to that, to my brothers, my niece, Delaney, that, you know, she's a little model in the making. I'm training her.
Okay.
Cheers to her. She's, you know.
How old is she?
My love right now. She's 3.
Oh, I love it.
She's a little mini me. I tell my sister, you know, she's supposed to be mine.
I just didn't get
she acts them. Like me and everything. I'm like, yeah, that's supposed to be mine.
I love it. Well, I'm going to give a cheers. Honestly, this is going to go out to you guys because I really love seeing Latinx people, Latinos, Latinas, and following their dreams. And especially in this industry where I know it's so difficult for us to get our foot in the door. I salute all of you guys.
Thank you so much. This bond you guys have, continue to uplift each other, continue
to work with each other. Yeah. And I wish all of you, all three of you, the much success that is going to be manifesting on you guys. Okay. So I hope the universe keeps blessing you guys and bringing you more opportunity. So I'm really proud of you guys. Cheers to all of you guys.
Thank you, Jackie. Cheers.
And you guys know that you guys can always come to Ladies Night. Any projects you guys have going on, anything that you want to promote. And if you're not in LA, we can do it through our streaming. So you guys can go anywhere from Dallas, hit us up. Definitely. So I might be going to Texas soon. So I'm going to hit y'all
up. Come on,
man. We'll go party.
Tequila shots. I'm hitting you up.
Tequila shots.
Texas don't have a party. I'm so mad I didn't bring tequila today.
I love partying.
I'm so mad.
I'm even madder.
It's okay. You're still in LA. Go have fun. Go drink. Go enjoy it. Go smoke.
Yeah, we're way ahead of you. I got you. Yeah.
Come on, Juan.
Hey. What time is your flight tomorrow, guys?
I think it's 2.
You got plenty of time,
man. Plenty of time.
You guys are
ready,
good.
Ready, you can still wake up good. In time, yeah. too. You know.
Good.
I love it. Well, shout out where people can find. Oh, what were you gonna say?
Yeah. Can I give a quick shout out?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I want to give a shout out to my boy Mike and my cousins, man, that have been there and supported me through this whole thing. My cousin Nelson, my cousin Juancho, and my brother Junior, my sister Yvette, man. I love it. For real, man.
Much say their love, names. You know what, Latinos, we got.
Yeah,
we
Juancho, Yvette, man, I love you, my sister,
I love
man.
It.
For real.
I love that. You want to give me a shout out?
Yeah, I want to shout out to everyone in Dallas, my whole cast and crew. I want to give a shout out to Michael Williams, Benji Films. I'll see you guys in Dallas. We got a lot of work to do. Shout out to everyone.
Hey.
I want to give a shout out to my family, my sister Emily, of course Delaney, my dad Saul, my mom Maria. I'm like, so many.
Everybody. Hey, that's how we family. Do it. That's how we do it.
And all the shout out to all the directors that I work with, you know, and shout out Dallas. We're definitely out there doing our thing.
That's
and
right.
And everybody's putting in the work.
Yeah.
So shout out to Dallas.
Shout out to Dallas.
Shout out to Dallas.
To the D, baby. Hey. To D Town, baby. You know what it is. 214. Thought you know.
Shout out LA too, though. I love it.
Yeah. Shout out LA, man. 213.
Where can people find you guys? Give a shout out your Instagram,
on Instagram,
sir. Your social medias.
At director Jay Solis at the Devil's Ring. The movie's out now. Please go check it out. I know you're gonna like it.
Okay.
I ain't gonna like it. They're gonna love it, goddamn.
Hey,
man. Devil's Ring corrected. For real. You can find me on Instagram, AlexanderTheG_. You can find me on Facebook, Alexander Luna.
Okay.
You can find me on Instagram at LindaHeidiDTX.
I love it. All right, you guys. Thank you so much for stopping by on Ladies Night. Yeah, loved having you guys. You're a good time. You're always welcome at Ladies Night and at TGN Latinx Studios. We have more shows if you guys ever want to jump on more shows here.
Yeah.
I'm going to shout them out. I know you guys were checking out Sexual Frequency. That's my girl, Lore. So I know. Ooh. Let me know when you guys want.
I might
want
to get on that one.
Okay. Yeah.
There you go.
I love it.
Sexual Frequency.
Yes.
We might need to like just pre-record him saying
might have to have you do a drop for that voiceover right there.
Yes.
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed tonight's episode. I hope you guys fun, and I hope you as the listeners had fun too. Carol Mommy's in there. She says Latinos in film are giving me life, you guys.
Yes.
So shout out to Carol Mommy. Yes. Thank you everybody who tuned in. We appreciate y'all. Make sure you subscribe to our channel and also download the Good News Radio app and check out TGN Latinx Studio. We have all the Latinx shows here, and make sure you support us, you know. Support the Latino in the industry, because if you want to see more in the industry, you got to support us from the very beginning.
Yeah.
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed tonight's episode. Please share us with your friends and your family. Thanks for tuning in. Thank you guys for being here. I am your host, Mysterious Jax. This is my girl Joe right here to my right. And this is Ladies Night Radio Show. And just remember one thing, ladies.
You are enough.
Hey. You are enough too.
Hey.
What about me?
So yeah, you're enough too. Remember, this is called Ladies Night, so I always give my girls love.
Yes,
so
yes.
The fellas, sometimes y'all be acting up, but I don't know.
I don't know. Y'all be doing some weird stuff.
Hey, but I'm an actor. Does that count?
Oh,
he
it counts.
Acting too much.
Acting way too much. All right, y'all. We'll see you next Friday. Same time, same place. Hey. Shout out to Bad Bunny. Love him. Hey, who going to the concert? No? Shout out to everybody. This is the After Hours right here with the Ladies Night. Right here we got the cast and the director of The Devil's Ring. We always give YouTube a sneak peek behind the cameras. Anything else you guys want to say and share with them about the film?
Yeah, it's available now, man. Go check it out. It's a great boxing movie. We got a lot of boxers in it, from Golden Boy. We got Virgil Ortiz Jr. We got Travell Mazian, Paul Ayala, a lot of great people.
I love it. We always got people popping up at Ladies Night. You know what it is. Wait, Maria, did you bring tequila?
Sure did.
Ah! Yeah. We got this on film. Shout out to my crazy.
Welcome, Crazy Maria.
Crazy Maria, that's my sister, y'all. Yay. And she always brings tequila. So that's why I didn't bring tequila, because she was supposed to be here earlier, but she got cut up at work. But it's okay. It's okay. We love you. We're still. No, I mean, see, she's hardworking. That's all. No, I know. But you told me you were coming. So we're going to give them a quick shot as, you know, guests of here in L.A. because they're not here from here. They're from Dallas. I mean, Texas. Texas. Yeah, yeah. Yes. So she's a Cowboys fan.
Oh, hey, man. Come on, man.
Yeah. She's a Cowboys fan.
So that through.
I really want to take her because I was telling them, I was like, I love Dallas. Dallas knows how to party. There's so much fun. And the stadium is beautiful.
I'm not going to disagree.
Right.
Just there in October.
Did you guys finish your wine?
Let's go.
Okay, we're going to use the same cups to put your tequila in.
You guys want
to
rinse them out if you want to, you know?
No, it's okay. It's a little out of taste. Hey. We're all right.
Okay. I was just asking here.
Can't get it. We're taking a shot on air just for you guys, so just letting y'all know we're on here. Let's see, what's the song that you
pick
guys
one,
like?
Pass it down. Pick one.
What song
Linda,
gets you
pick
hype?
One, Linda.
Ooh. What song gets y'all hype?
She got the jams. Go for it.
I love Rauw Alejandro right now.
Okay, let me see.
What did she say?
Oh yeah, I like him too. I don't know why I always pronounce it Raul.
I was saying Raul.
I was like, oh, it's Raul. Okay. I don't know. How did you say it again?
It's Rauw Alejandro.
Raul. See, I was calling him Raul. I was like, that's Raul right there. That's my pocha ass. It's okay, though. Hey, I own it. Okay, I own it.
Yeah, hey,
I own it.
Hey, that was Vegas.
So much fun. We had so much fun. We played on the craps table. Shout out to my sister. My sister taught me how to play craps in Vegas. And this past time I went to Vegas, I won about like close to $700. So good. It was really good. I don't play nothing else but the craps. And I'm telling you, you got to go. When's the last time you've been to Vegas, Juan?
Shit, like 6 years ago. I'm going back with the vengeance.
Man,
are you serious? 6 years ago?
Well, they're from Texas.
To go back.
Oh, you're right. I forget because, like, I guess if you're from LA, like, you know, you're more inclined to visit Vegas.
Yeah, yeah.
And I go to Vegas a lot because I play softball. So like we have a lot of tournaments out there.
Oh, wow.
So I have a lot of friends from Texas. I just got put onto him. They fly out to Vegas. I'm like, I'm a boy in Vegas. I go. It's very strong.
When I found out about the free alcohol and all that shit.
2000s R&B vibe.
Yeah. I was gambling all day.
Old school R&B, that's my shit. So when I heard him, I was like, damn, who is this? But yeah, I just got put on.
I got you.
Yes.
No more, sis. But you this is my cup if you want. Oh, for them? You know, they might have some next door, but. Oh, okay. Hold on. She just told me that she just learned about Blast.
I just learned about Blast.
Do you guys know who Blast is? LA artist.
I just got put onto him.
You guys gotta check him out. This is him right here. His sound is so dope. He has some great music, but yeah, this is him. You guys gotta check him out. I realize a lot of people don't know about Blast.
It's wide open. It gives me like 2000 R&B vibes. Yay. That's why I like it so much.
Oh, here. You can listen to it. Woo-hoo. All right.
Okay, I didn't know that was him.
Yeah, that's Blast.
Oh, you're right. Yes. I know the song.
I just got to know.
I'll play it for y'all. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed the show. We're going to go ahead and take our shots and we're going to be out of here. Thank you guys. On the count of three, we're going to take a shot. Let me just take a little bit with them.
Karen, mommy said the devil's ring, $12.99 on iMovies. About to watch it with the husband.
Thank you, Carol.
Carol, mommy's going to buy you a devil's ring right now.
Shout out to Carol.
Carol. All right. Peace. Peace. Pa arriba.
Pa arriba.
Pa abajo. pa'l centro, pa' dentro.
Woo! Ooh, damn, that's strong. All right, y'all. Ooh. See y'all later next Friday. Love y'all. Let me end it.